During the hiatus, a man in a black suit appeared in the Geist Gallery in Toronto and identified himself as a builder of ornithopters. Or perhaps he said he was a promoter of ornithopters. This was during the hiatus, when nothing was clear. In any case, his field was ornithoptery. I couldn't remember what an ornithopter was, but I could see one in my mind. The question was, what did an ornithopter do? The ornithopter man was accompanied by a well-dressed woman who never stopped smiling. Smiling seemed to be her work, what she did, in the sense that one is expected to be doing something during one's time on this plane. What exactly is it you do? We imagine asking, and we imagine her reply. Her teeth were white. They gleamed. At least they gleam now, in memory. Her smile was not unpleasant, but it was continuous. It never went anywhere. It was always there in the room. Never got off the drawing board, is what we mean to say. might be described as a vacancy that encroaches from the rear. The hiatus that I speak of caught up with me in the spring, when the world was waking up, but seemed to me to be falling asleep. I was alone with the sound of my breathing and the voice of the man who could bend spoons with his mind. Soon calls were coming in to the radio talk show from excited listeners whose broken clocks were starting up everywhere in North America, but not where I was, in the hiatus. Streets of the city, pursued by the grating sound of a skateboard approaching from behind, louder, urgent, rhythmic. Step scrape, step scrape. My ankles is impossible to send messages from within a hiatus. group of tourists appear at the video camera. Then dog walkers began to appear, and buggy pushers, teenagers, strollers, a wheelchair pusher pushing an invalid in a red Anorak slouched deep in a chair. Wheelchair pusher stopped at the edge of the grass and moved away from the wheelchair and began performing exercises that looked like Tai Chi in the movie. A small group of aging powerlifters marched across the sand. And now, the boing-boing bounce of basketballs could be heard from the tennis court up the hill. Smiling grimly, and soon he was moving at terrific speed down the hill and across the street. shrapnel gun filled with black plastic bullets stuck to the first of them. Then I felt the center of the hiatus passing over me, like the eye of a hurricane. All I had to do now was hang on and wait.